Hi, I'm Kevin Brown with BSS Audio. In this video series, I'll introduce some fundamental concepts for working with BSS audio devices within Audio Architect. First, we'll look at virtual wiring within block diagrams. Then, we'll take a look at the powerful signal naming feature. And then, we'll discuss how to visually troubleshoot audio signals. Let's begin. An open architecture device, such as a BSS Audio Soundweb London Blue 100, is configured using virtual wires. Let's go over some tips and tricks for working with these wires. Starting with the basics, to draw a wire, click and release on a connection point, and then click and release on another one. This also works in reverse. You can start at the destination, click and release, and bring it back to the source, click and release. To delete a wire, I select it either by clicking directly on it or by drawing a fence entirely around it, and I press delete on my keyboard. Right-click delete also works. If you prefer the visual look of right angles, just click and release, click and release again, and again, and again. There's my right angle. There's even a no diagonals option, which will only allow me to create right angles when it's turned on. Notice that the large white squares allow me to move parts of the wire like this. And the small white squares allow me to move parts of the wire like this. To create a Y split, simply double-click on an existing wire and then single-click on another input. Now I have one signal essentially being copied and sent to another destination. This, of course, is one of the many advantages of digital over analog, because it's a perfect copy and there's no loss in signal quality. Also, there's no limit on the number of Y splits you can create. Simply double-click again, and there's another Y split which can be single-clicked onto some other input. Now this one signal is reaching many destinations using nothing but wires. However, if I want to do the opposite, taking many signals and sending them to one destination, I can't just jam them all into the same destination. Notice that a white wire means everything's okay, but yellow means something's wrong. So instead, I need to use a processing object which can mix signals together. For example, the mixer can do that. There are several other processing objects that can mix signals together, but the takeaway here is that distributing one to many can be accomplished through Y splits, but mixing many to one requires some kind of processing object. I talked about how to delete a wire entirely, but what if you want to delete just a small segment of a wire? Here's how. Click and release anywhere on the wire so it's selected, then click and hold on a small white square, and drag it onto the square immediately before or after it. And release. Now just that segment has been deleted. To connect several connection points together, you can do this one wire at a time, of course, but here's a shortcut. First, draw a fence around not the entire object, but just the connection points, and they'll turn purple. Then click and release any one of those points, it doesn't matter which. Now you're in multi-wire mode, and you can just click somewhere else to connect all the signals at once. This also works from destination to source. and it even works across vertically aligned processing objects. There's also a trick for creating right angles when multi-wiring. As before, I'll enter multi-wire mode by drawing a fence and clicking on anything purple. But now I'll press and hold the left or right arrow key on my keyboard. This staggers the wires, and I can click to plant them down like this. Now let's say I want to take this one signal and Y-split it to all of these destinations. In other words, I'd like to create a broadcast of wires. There's a trick for that too. First, enter multi-wire mode, starting at the destinations. As always, I draw a fence, then click something purple. Now the trick is to hold C on your keyboard. That bunches them together, at which point you can just click and release at the source. It's important to do this from destination to source, and not the other way around, for reasons mentioned previously. All but one wire will be broken. If you prefer to work from source to destination to create broadcast wires, then there's a trick for that too. Click and release once, and then again to establish a wire segment, and then press any number on your keyboard from 2 through 9. For example, if I need 8 splits, then I press the number 8 on my keyboard, and then I click and release to connect them somewhere. A wire tag is a tool you can use to reduce clutter in your block diagrams by making portions of wire invisible. For example, this is functionally the same as this. The only difference is visual. The wire tag is just allowing this portion to be invisible. To create a wire tag, just right-click and select Wire Tag. That gives you a single transmitter and receiver. Notice that selecting one causes a green box to identify the other, which is useful for quick analysis. If you have more than one wire tag, it starts to become difficult to analyze the block diagram. So for each wire tag, it's helpful to go to Properties and select a unique color. This makes the wire tags easier to visually follow. And along those same lines, if the wire tag components are far apart from each other, watch what happens when I click this arrow. It automatically pans to that part of the screen. Please note that wire tags are not for sharing audio between physical devices. That's a common misconception. For that, you would typically use things like AVB, Bluelink, Cobranet, or Dante. Instead, wire tags are completely optional tools for removing virtual wiring clutter within a single physical device. Just like regular wires, a wire tag can be split. This is done by right-clicking either component and then selecting Create End Tag. This will create a Y-split of the signal in the form of a wire tag, which can then easily be moved wherever you want within this device. Therefore, a wire tag always has just one transmitter and one or more receivers. A wire tag can also carry multiple channels. For example, if these 8 signals are needed in some distant part of the block diagram, then I can add a wire tag, go to its properties, and tell it to be 8 channels. Now I can connect the signals to the transmitter. And connect the receiver to the destinations. And if the 8 signals need to reach multiple destinations, then I can easily create another end tag as discussed before, and I get another Y-split of all 8 channels.